สวัสดีค่ะ Welcome back to Custom Knowledge Clips. Today we will explain about duty free zone.
Tax incentives. Duty free zone. What is duty free zone? Duty free zone is an area designated for a benefit of a custom duty in an industrial, commercial operation or operations of other activities beneficial to the nation's economy. Goods brought into a duty free zone shall be entitled to a duty exemption or a duty refund by laws. A permission for the establishment of a duty-free zone is granted by the Director General in accordance with rules, procedures, and conditions specified in the ministerial regulations. It is considered as a tax measure on the promotion of trade and investment in line with the revised Kyoto Convention. There are four types of privileges for goods imported into the kingdom to be brought into a duty-free zone. 1. Privileges under the custom law. For instance, exemption for the import duty, exemption of the export duty for exported goods, exemption of standard control, etc. 2. Privileges under the law on customs tariff. For instance, duty rate deduction or duty exemption. 3. Privileges under the excise law, exemption of the excise tax for goods imported into the kingdom to be brought into a duty-free zone. 4. Privileges under the Revenue Code of Thailand, exemption of value-added tax or VAT, or a payment of 0% VAT. There are two types of operators who can request for privileges in a duty-free zone. 1. A licensee to establish a duty-free zone. 2. A licensee to operate a business in a duty-free zone. Two main steps of the establishment of a duty-free zone are as follows. 1. A request for the license. 2. A request for operation. First step. Smaller steps of a request for the license are as follows. Examine documents. Inspect the to-be-established area proposed to the Director General for consideration. Issue a license to establish a duty-free zone. Examination of documents of a request for the license to establish a duty-free zone. This is to check whether a requester's qualifications, disqualifications, rules and conditions are in accordance with the custom notification. During document examination, in case any incorrect or incomplete documents are found, a custom officer shall request for additional ones and or dispose the request out of the list within the period of time specified in the custom notification. Area inspection. During this step, a customs officer shall inspect the area to consider its suitability for the establishment of a duty-free zone. Proposal for Director General's consideration. During this step, a customs officer shall propose a request form and related documents for the establishment of the duty-free zone to the Director General. When the Director General approves the permission for the establishment of a duty-free zone, a licensee to establish a duty-free zone shall proceed the following steps. Pay an annual fee and a license fee for a duty-free zone. Deposit a bank guarantee. Sign in a contract of insurance and a bond with security for establishment of the duty-free zone. After all processes are followed by a requester, the Customs Department shall then issue the license to establish a duty-free zone. Second step, requesting for operation of a duty-free zone. Once the licensee has prepared the readiness of the duty-free zone according to the rules and conditions, the request for operation must be submitted to the Customs Department. Readiness of the area. Customs officers from Tax Incentives Division and Customs Office or Custom House who are in charge of supervising the duty-free zone, the requested area, co-inspect the area. The consideration for operation of a duty-free zone shall be in accordance with the rules and conditions specified in the customs notification. Proposal for operation. After readiness of the requested area is inspected, a custom officer shall propose a request to operate a duty-free zone to the Director General. In case the Director General has granted the permission, the Custom Department shall announce the custom notification to the public and return the bank guarantee to the licensee. After a duty-free zone has started the operation, the licensee is able to request for a license to operate a business in his duty-free zone, or optionally have other parties to get the said license instead. However, a requester for the license to operate a business in a duty-free zone shall also be qualified in line with the rules and conditions specified in related custom notifications. These are what to know about the establishment of a duty-free zone.